Hello everyone, my name is Sai from Design Plus Code, and welcome to a brand new course called UIKit for iOS 15. I'm so pleased to bring this course to you, as I will teach you the fundamentals of UIKit. Now we've heard a lot in the past few years about Swift UI, but we can't forget that UIKit is the fundamental framework upon which a lot of iOS apps run today, and so I'm pleased to show you what we'll be building in this course. This is the Figma file we'll be basing our app off of, and you can see that we have a lot of screens in here. Now this course will be split into two parts. In the first part, I will show you some of the fundamentals that we will go over, and in the second part, we'll see how we can take our apps to the next level and work with some backend. But to get started, these are the screens we'll be building. We have this featured homepage over here, and yes, this app is going to be a resemblance of the Design Plus Code app. In this featured homepage, we can see that we have a course highlighted with this custom and beautiful blur view, and we can see that this same page translates well when the user has their app inside of dark mode. We can see that unlike the typical tab bar we are presented with, we have this amazing blur behind this tab bar. And yes, all of the icons you see here are using Apple's very own SF Symbols 3. And so I will show you how you can use SF Symbols. As we scroll down, we can see that we're presented with new data that is presented in this organized view. And in UIKit, there are two ways to present data, either through a table view or a collection view. And I'll show you how you can work with both views to display data dynamically. You can also see that within the homepage, we're changing the title of both screens. And I'll show you how we can use scroll detection to modify the layout of our app and customize content on there. In the second tab, we can see some more examples of this collection view and the table view. All along, we're using SF symbols, making sure that our app adapts well in both dark mode and as well as different screens, whether it be an iPhone or an iPad. In UIKit, we use auto layout to accomplish this. And while auto layout may be daunting to some fellow programmers, I can show you how it's nothing to be afraid of. Finally, the last screen we'll be building inside of part one of this app is the detail view. And you can see in this detail view, we're presented with amazing illustrations brought to you from the Design Plus Code team, along with some information about the sections presented in each course. While we'll be hard coding the courses for now, in part two of the course, I'll show you how you can get data from a database and present it all using the UIKit framework. Now to build this application, as I mentioned, we'll be using UIKit. And while some programmers may use pure code to simply build an app, we at Design Plus Code believe in making the transition from designers to coders and vice versa as smoothly as possible. And so that's why we'll be using Xcode's very own storyboards. This is a way for us to quickly design and code our app very quickly and get a visual representation of how our app might look. You can see in the storyboard over here, I've laid out some of the views we might be using. Everything is selectable and draggable. Every view element you see can be customized. And while there are a lot of options here to choose from, I'll walk you through all of them in this course so it's not daunting at all. Furthermore, we're going to see how we can use storyboards to connect it to our code. Over here, I have a preview, but when I switch over to the assistant, I can see all the code that's related to this particular storyboard. I can also see how all the views are aligned. And so once I have all the code connected to every element I've dropped in the storyboard, all it becomes is a matter of connecting the code back and forth and making sure that our code works as expected and our app functions as desired. And so what does the final output look? Well, I'm pleased to give you a preview of the app we'll be building. Switching over to the screen over here, if I pull up my simulator, you can see that we currently have our app functioning inside of dark mode. We can see this matches our Figma file almost exactly. We can see that as we scroll, the title of the navigation bar changes, as well as the name of the tab down below. We have these views displayed over here, and this isn't a view that was created three different times, but rather one time, and we had UIKit copy it over with our custom data. This is an example of a table view, but the very same thing can be applied to collection views as we have over here. Now the whole app is running inside of dark mode, but I'd like to show you what it looks like inside of light mode. So if I switch over to light mode, we can see that our app looks just as beautiful with the custom blur views previewing what's about to show up, as well as the collection views we have over here. Now I'd like to show you some of the transitions we're having. If I click on React Hooks Advanced, we have a very simple cross-dissolve animation that takes us to the page showing all the sections in this course, as well as giving us some brief intro about this course. Clicking on this button, I can display the brand new UI menu object that has been introduced at Apple's WWDC. I can close and go back to the application. With auto layout, we can also see how our app still looks gorgeous when displayed in multiple view layouts by making no element too big and everything readable. Speaking of readable, it's very important that I show you how accessibility is crucial for your users. We at Design Plus Code prioritize accessibility for all, and so it is important that we teach you how you can make your apps accessible. If I go back to the homepage and go over to settings, I can change the dynamic type of this application, and thus I can increase the font size if I so desire. So within settings, I can go to accessibility, display and text size, then I can go to larger text, and I can increase the size of the text, maybe make it a little big like this, and immediately as I switch back, you can see that all the text is slightly bigger, but our app still looks amazing and it's able to display all the data that's needed. Same thing goes over here. And with that, I'm very pleased to welcome you to this course once more, and I can't wait to show you all that we'll be covering in this course. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you all in the next couple of sections. Thank you.